Your name is Yahweh. Yahweh is your name.
When we talk about prayer, we are not talking about asking means. Mm-hmm. Asking means is not only the way of prayer.
Mm-hmm.
Praying is making your heart understand what God is willing to do in your life.
Amen.
That's praying.
Mm-hmm.
It's not convincing God to do what he is reluctant from doing.
Mm-hmm.
It is you agreeing that what God is really interesting to release in your life. That is what we call prayer. It's intimacy. It's prayer that is brings us to the place of intimacy. And that is why even we fast because we yearn for his presence. It's for intimacy purposes. And intimacy is what brings revelation knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
And revelation knowledge is what releases faith, and faith is what gives us authority. So once we commit ourselves into the place of prayer, we are lifted up. The hotel prayer is the hotel power. So we are lifted up in the place of God, in the realm of the spirit. Yesterday I was teaching in our church, and I was giving solution why church is not listed as an essential service provider in this pandemic. It's because we have left our spirituality. So once we go back to our spirituality, we embrace our spirituality, we get into the gifts of the Holy Spirit, we begin to walk in this gift of the Holy Spirit, we shall be having meaning in the society, because that is how we function. We were created to function spiritually. That is how a believer is supposed to function. And once you fail to pray, you are removed away from the connection. Prayer is what sockets you into the presence of the Lord. So yeah. You are connected. You can cultivate the presence of God as you pray. So prayer is something that is very important. Prayer is a means of covenant activation. I said three things that activate covenant. Is prayer, praise, and sacrifice. Prayer being the key of them. Mm-hmm. So once you are distressed, once you are greatly distressed and things are not working out, you need to encourage yourself in the Lord and find strength to pray. When David was raided and met that the wife has been taken, all things have been taken, and the houses have been burnt,
yeah.
And all things are happening like that. Men want to stone him because of what he has done. He was greatly distressed. But what did he do? He encouraged himself in the Lord. And he asked for an effort. An effort is a garment of prayer.
Yeah.
He pulled a garment of prayer and began to seek God.
Amen.
And when he began to seek God, he prayed and asked, "Shall I pursue them? Shall I go against these people?" And God gave him direction. Where do you get direction of that marriage? Prayer. Where do you get revelation? Prayer. Where do you get connection to God's power? Prayer. Where are activation of your gifting? Prayer. So prayer, prayer, prayer. Even if you don't feel like praying,
pray.
Even if it is not coming, force it until you pray. Because if you don't pray, prayerlessness is what opens the door for the devil. We resist the devil when we continue praying and charging ourselves.
Amen.
When we are charged in faith, we are strong.
Amen.
So a family that prays together always stays together. So I don't say there is anything that can keep you away from prayer. If it keeps you away from prayer, then it has killed you.
So even the time you feel like you cannot pray, just pray.
Pray.
Even if you feel like you don't want to go to church.
If force yourself.
Go to church, pray and pray everywhere.
And pray.
Even
if you don't feel like doing that,
just
you are
pray.
So hooded. Your husband has become like a devil. Where do you chase the devil? Go to prayer. Rise, go to the church, pray.
Pray,
don't say that I was so down that I never went to church. The devil has succeeded.
Yeah.
If your battles make you not to pray, then the enemy has defeated you.
Yeah.
But when you get trouble and you pray, that's the change. Situation changes when we pray.
Amen.
We are able to turn around situation.
Amen.
When you pray, you are oppressed, you pray. When there is no breakthrough, you pray. When enemies rise against you, you pray. The prayer is the only weapon.
And the Lord will hear the cry, yeah. And you'll come and rescue.
And we'll come and rescue.
Now something that you have mentioned. Mm. You are saying that we have left the place of spirituality. Mm. And many people, they are being fought daily by the schemes of the devil. You should not be spiritual. Don't be
you
spiritual.
Need to be very spiritual. I say this always when I'm teaching and I'm telling people, the world says, don't be spiritual. And they're telling you, don't be spiritual. I tell people, don't be foolish. Don't be stupid. Don't try to make spiritual things look foolish.
Yeah.
Be right. Do what is right. Because the knowledge of the cross, the message of the cross is foolishness to them that are perishing, but power to them that believe.
Yeah.
So be very spiritual. The devil wants to make you carnal.
God is preaching.
So that he can defeat you. You need to be very spiritual. Even marriage is very spiritual.
Yeah.
It's more spiritual than physical. Everything that we do in marriage is symbolic of spiritual.
Mm.
Worship. Sex is symbolic of worship when it comes to marriage. And other things that we do. So we need to be very spiritual. Don't allow anybody to tell you don't be spiritual. Be very spiritual. Pray always in the spirit. Talk in tongues everywhere, even in your kitchen. Talk in tongues. Because when you talk in tongues, you identify yourself. You are not talking to men, but talking unto angels. So you are talking unto God. You need to identify yourself. He who speaks in tongues identifies himself. So you need to try talks in tongues every minute.
Mm-hmm.
Try to talk in tongues even when you are driving. Try to talk in tongues even when you are eating. You can even step your meal a bit and start talking in tongues for a few minutes. Build yourself.
Hallelujah.
Through that. And you will become strong. So take seriously the life of worship. That is where a refreshing will come. Refreshing comes from the presence of the Lord. Don't quit the presence. Don't quit the presence. Let the cultivate that presence. And I want to tell you, you will always be refreshed. When you pray and you pray in the spirit, you are refreshed.
Amen.
So renewal comes from the presence of God. Revival comes from the presence of the Lord. And when you do that, you are going to be blessed.
Mm-hmm.
Then we said also, apart from prayer, for you to need to be refreshed again, you are supposed to be committed to serve God. When you leave the post of worship or the post of service, you risk losing the power of God that comes to refresh you. Those who wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength.
Amen.
Those who wait upon the Lord. This waiting is the waiter, like the waiter in the hotel.
Mm.
The waiter in the hotel waiting to serve. Those who wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength.
Yeah.
And they shall mount with their wings like eagles. So serve the Lord. That's where the renewal comes.
Mm.
The renewal comes also as you continue to serve. Some couples, the reason why they are facing hard times in their marriages is because they relented. They are not serving God the way they were serving God when they were singles. They are not serving God. Their commitment died. And if you married a brother who is committed, a sister who is committed, and all of a sudden you have withdrawn your services to God, you will faint away. Because strength comes from the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
When the youth are fainting, those who wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength, and they shall mount with their wings like eagles.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to be committed to serve the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
That is a area of refreshing, and that is where God keep on rewarding. I say, a good marriage is a reward that we get from God after serving Him. We don't serve God because we have gotten married. We serve Him even before we get married.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, He is able to reward us. And we walk in righteousness. When we walk in righteousness, God is always protecting us from demonic counterattacks, from every force that comes to destroy our lives. We are shielded by God and we are renewed. Remember, there is a manner that stays in the presence of the Lord. And a manner that stays in the presence of the Lord does not get spoiled.
Yeah.
The manner that stays in the presence of God does not get spoiled. So it doesn't matter how perishable you are. When you stay in the presence of God, you cannot you cannot perish.
You can't.
And one of the things that those who overcome, God will give them ability to test that manner.
Mm.
That manner that has been in the presence of the Lord. And you need to be that man. You need to be that woman. Don't fade in the services of God. Try everything to remain where God wants you to be. And as you do it, God will keep on protecting you, blessing you, and giving you energy that you need. We are and the anointed, given new oil because we are serving. You cannot be given new oil when we are not serving.
Yeah.
So serving is what makes you have the new oil. Remember that if you park your car, even if the oil goes bad because of the matter of stay, the expiry time, and the car is not moving, the gauge will not show. The gauge. But there is a car that moves, and the gauge shows this car needs service. And you are taking the service. The same way in the things of God. So once you are serving, you are renewed. The energy comes.
Amen.
And anointing comes.
Amen.
And the new energy
Amen.
Is released unto your life.
Amen.
I mean, God help us to go back to the place of worship
Amen.
And serve God more than ever before. I mean, God help us also to be committed to prayer.
Amen.
That you can pray without ceasing. You keep on praying. You love prayer. And prayer becomes your lifestyle. When prayer becomes your lifestyle, I want to tell you, you are able to sustain and maintain your marriage, and you are going to keep it, and you are going to also to be blessed, because God will bless you, and God will keep you. Then another thing, there are so many couples that are frustrated because they are not receiving the basic needs in marriage. And we have talked about this severally. Basic needs. What does a man need to function? What does a woman need to function? If the woman is not given what she needs to function,
mm-hmm.
she will not function and she will be frustrated.
Yeah.
You will cause her not to function and you will cause yourself not to function. So when the woman is not given love or affection, when the woman is not given attention, when a woman is not given that trust and honesty from the husband, when the woman is not given security, when the woman is not given family commitment, that means that woman will be frustrated. That woman will be frustrated, and even her husband will join her in that frustration. If the man is not given honor and respect, if the man is not given sexual fulfillment, if the man is not given accompaniment, or you don't accompany him, you are not a companion to him when it comes to recreational activities, then this man will not function. You are not attractive. Spouse, you have lost your beauty on the way. This man will not be happy. And when also you are not giving him peace, or what we call domestic support,
mm-hmm.
so the home is becoming a bad place for him.
Mm-hmm.
So he will not be happy. He will be frustrated. But once a man receives this, he is able to function. So make sure that you provide what a man needs in that marriage relationship. And we said again, what it makes people face the burnouts in marriage is because this man or this family or this married couple, they are living their marriage life to impress the outsiders. And we said you live your life. Don't try to impress men.
Mm-hmm.
Don't try to impress any women around there. Don't try to prove any point. Don't be real. Don't be fake.
Yeah.
And this one you're not fake. You cannot pretend for long. When you pretend, you'll faint out in some way or another. You are going to faint out. You are not going to faint out when you are yourself.
Yes, yes.
When you are running your race, you know where you are going. You understand that. We said also what it makes many couple begin to fade out, and or they begin to face that we call burnout, is because they are trying to impress the wrong partner in marriage. You married this person and you know this person is wrong for you, but you are living it. You are dying trying to impress this person, and this person does not see you, does not love you back, does not see anything that you are doing. There is nothing. You try to impress this person, this wrong partner, or a person who has been already bewitched in the mind.
Yeah.
So this person is not getting to connect with you. You try everything. You work for it and you impress everything. You can give him money. You can give her money. You can do everything. But her heart is not getting to where you want. That one also you say, I am sick and tired.
Yeah.
I've done everything that I should.
Mm.
But I am tired. This happens to many marriages. That's why we want those who are not yet married. Don't marry for anything else. Marry for love. If you see there's a problem there and you don't love this person, you are forcing yourself. You cannot force yourself for long. This thing will fade away.
Yes.
And you need to understand that And then another thing, that those who fear to lose that marriage. So you fear. Yes, some people are in marriage, but they fear.
Mm-hmm.
You fear to lose the marriage, you fear. And fear has become the owner of your life. You're fearing to lose life. You're fearing to lose the marriage. Mm-hmm. And we say in Isaiah 24, and that is where we need to learn a lesson from. Isaiah 24, especially verse 17, tells us there are these things that are against us as long as we are inhabitants of the earth. As long as we live on earth, these things will come. Number one, there is fear, there is pit, and there is snare. And this say, then whoever runs away from the noise of fear shall go into the pit. And whoever comes out of the pit, you try to come out of the pit, you meet yourself going into the snare. So the easiest way to avoid yourself from entering into the pit, avoid listening to the noise of fear. Ignore it.
Then the noises of marriage.
Just so people make a lot of noise. And they tell you this will not work. They want to install fear in you.
Mm-hmm.
Men are being left, especially at this age, especially at this time, especially at this age, and it's this men that and you hear those things. And when you hear them, you are afraid. Some people, when you are approaching, sometimes you are afraid. Although you have a background history, you know, your mother told you, I was left when I had this time. And the way I loved my husband. And now you are putting yourself into those shoes. So fear has come because of the background.
And also the devil can use some people.
Yeah.
I remember, I think some years back, and she was a pastor.
Mm.
She came and told me, I can see you're very connected with your husband.
Mm.
But be prepared, when he reaches 45, when he is a minister, he turns to become something else. They turn.
Mm-hmm.
They just go out, they begin to sleep with ladies at the age of 45. And I told her, that will never be my portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So I denounced, I never welcomed that fear. Now tell me, somebody can be installed
with fear.
Someone can come and tell you, prepare. When men are at 45, they are all the same, even though they are the men of God. And of course, some people have seen the men of God.
They have experience.
Yeah, and behave in a funny way.
Mm-hmm.
So when you are told like that, and there are some things that you're seeing out there, you are already fearful from inside.
Mm-hmm.
And you begin to wait for the evil rather than fighting evil and wait for good.
Mm-hmm.
So those noises are there, and there are people can be used. They can be used. If you're not careful, you can prepare from bad times instead of preparing for good times.
They affect your faith.
Yeah.
And your expectation goes lower.
Mm-hmm.
And remember, the Bible says God will meet the expectations of the righteous. They will not fail. So don't fear. Whatever you fear comes around you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So that's the biggest weapon that the devil uses against us, fear. So don't succumb to the spirit of fear.
Amen.
Run away from it.
Mm.
And you will be able to overcome, and God is going to bless you, and you are going to see things happening in a greater way.
Amen.
In your marriage.
Amen.
And then there are some people who have given up also to criticisms and even accusations.
Yeah.
You have been criticized so much. And you criticize, you are not fit for this person, you are not fit for this. This comes and attack after attack. There are people who see you unworthy. There are people who see you unworthy to have even that partner.
There are people
who see you unworthy to be in that marriage.
Mm.
There's people who see you unworthy to have that wife, to have that husband. And those people will criticize. Criticism will come out. But we are not supposed to give up to those criticism and also to accusations. There are so many accusations that come. And these are weapons of the devil. And once you allow them, they will weaken you. And some people have been injured. Because the purpose of criticism and accusation is to injure you. And once you are injured, you become weak. You are injured. And there are some people that this is what has brought their marriage on their knees.
As you're talking, I'm just looking at it. There are people, especially those who have gone into a field of warfare.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to the in-laws.
Mm.
since day one, you are not accepted in that family, either the mother-in-law, the sisters, everybody never accepted. And now you just fought your way out, and you broke through, and you got married. But together with that, they are always against you. They say they curse the day you came into that family. You are an outcast. So they never...
We call that one oppressions. We call them oppression from the in-laws. There are some in-laws that can oppress, because those oppressions come because they have never accepted. And not even in-laws alone.
Yeah.
They are those even oppressed by friends. Even attacked by friends who thought you are not qualifying, or maybe you left them unfairly, got married. We call them toxic company. They are toxic. And they have been working out with you. So when you are under that kind of attack persistently from in-laws, from those crowns that you thought they are friends, but they never meant good for you, those oppressions make some people get tired, because you're fighting wars. And this is prolonged. When it is if it is short, you can easily go over. Prolonged attack, prolonged oppression, it will make you weak. The Bible says there was a war for a long time
between
the house of David
and
the house of Saul.
Yeah.
And the house of Saul became weaker and weaker. So I want you to know this. If you allow yourself to become the house of Saul, that's the reject, you will become weaker. But once you are aligning yourself with God, you get strength from God, and you can become stronger and stronger than your opposition. So if you conquered and got married, you cannot lose it because of the same oppression. Because what they wanted to stop you from getting married. That was their aim. That is their aim, to make sure that you are not getting married by that son, you are not getting married by that person.
Yeah.
That is what was their aim, to stop that marriage. But if marriage succeeded, the way you succeeded into getting married, you can also succeed in keeping that marriage. So you can still overcome them. You are superior than them. If you killed bears, you can also kill the giant called Goliath. So that is why you need to strengthen yourself and say, I cannot give up. I cannot lose hope. Because of this, I am going to be strong. I am going to be strong. And I am going to conquer. So oppressions from the in-laws are reasons for many people also to get tired and get tired in their marriage relationship.
I think I need to still add something on that. The word of the Lord says the battle that was in between these two houses, the house of Saul and the house of David. The house of David grew stronger and stronger. What governed the house of David is the word, is the word of God.
Amen.
What God spoke concerning the house of David. So this is the right time we seek to know what God really spoke. Every word that God speaks in our lives must be proved. It must be tested. The word that the Lord spoke concerning your family, that word will be tested. So no matter how long the battle can take, David took around 13 years running away from his enemies before he got access on the throne. Joseph himself, it took him around 13 years before he got into a place of enthronement. So the fact that your marriage is God ordained does not mean that you not meet with some battles. And when it comes to the in-law battles, understand you not kill your in-laws. You not kill them. They are here to remain. So it is you
that you're supposed to fight. Mm-hmm. And how do you fight? Mm-hmm. You need to be very strong from inside.
Mm-hmm.
You need to load yourself with the word of God and that information. Mm-hmm. That I never came into this marriage mm-hmm. just because I saw this man and I got impressed. I came into his life because God spoke.
Mm-hmm.
Now God, you spoke and God, you gave you that man. Mm-hmm. He is the Almighty God who will come through you. Mm-hmm. So I'm giving up because they are just cursing you daily. They are just saying that you are an abomination that in that family,
mm-hmm.
that you don't fit their brother or their relative. You should not succumb to those ones.
Mm-hmm.
You must be very strong and every time calling upon the name of God and praying for them to get understanding, mm-hmm. to get the revelation.
Mm-hmm.
Because if that battle is prolonged,
mm-hmm.
and you get the burnout, if you are not strong from inside, you pack your things and go.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't pack your things and go, you begin to put pressure to your husband, telling him, oh, we need to come out of this place. Maybe it is because I am near them. If you don't go and do MBCD to your people, I'll leave you. So already what you have gotten from the in-laws, you come with the same distress, with the same burnout, and you begin to bring it to your husband or even to your wife.
Mm-hmm.
There are husbands who have never been accepted
mm-hmm.
by their in-laws.
Yes,
they see this man as if he was an opportunist,
mm-hmm.
especially to have their daughter. So anytime they see their daughter, they see you as an obstacle.
Mm-hmm.
They see this man as something that came to obstruct even the vision of their daughter.
Mm-hmm.
So the couple must be out to know or to understand that this is a force that we are fighting with.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, if you allow that kind of oppression, you may quit and you may not
like that marriage
or make it in your marriage.
Mm-hmm.
So it is good to be covered by the word.
Amen.
That God gave unto you, that God spoke concerning that family. Whoever is always is led by the word of God
mm-hmm.
overcomes at the end of it.
Yeah,
at
you will win.
Yeah,
you will win those battles.
Amen.
But we say now, and that's why we say this, give people peace, mm-hmm. especially the in-laws.
Yeah.
You gain nothing by separating people.
Mm-hmm.
You just plant a seed of discord, and this is what you shall reap later in life.
Yeah.
So I pray that every one of you learn that lesson.
Amen.
That you need to give people support.
Mm-hmm.
When you see them, they're in marriage, give them support that they need. And that is a blessing, and that you reap something good also
Amen.
For your life.
Amen.
So oppression also, we agree, it can bring the burnout. That oppression brings also the burnout. And we pray that you come out of that
Amen.
Kind of oppression
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever is sent out to oppress your marriage,
Amen.
We kill it we by its root.
This
in the name of Jesus.
Jesus
those who have never attained their Shaka independence, anytime they, from the time they got married,
yeah.
you have been oppressed battle after battle, this sister, this aunt, you have never rested.
Mm.
We pray in the name of Jesus that you shall know rest.
Amen.
That you shall be able to enjoy your marriage.
Amen.
And whatever is attacking you, we bring
Praise
it
Lord.
Down.
In
the mighty
Jesus.
Name, of,
the
Jesus,
name of Jesus.
And we decree you shall know peace.
Yes.
I say you shall know peace.
Shall know
and whatever
peace.
Is causing fear in your life,
yes.
we scare it away.
Yes.
We declare boldness is your portion.
Amen.
The Bible says the righteous are as bold as a lion.
Amen.
And I declare that shall be your portion.
Hallelujah.
That you shall not fear
Hallelujah.
Because you have not received the spirit of fear
yes.
but of boldness
Amen.
We have received the spirit of sonship
Amen.
So we are sons and we are not supposed to be afraid
Amen.
So we destroy fear
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
And we decree fear Amen. As no roots again
Jesus.
In your life in the name of Jesus
Amen.
And we decree in the name of Jesus you shall rise above every kind of accusation.
Amen.
You shall rise above every kind of criticism.
Amen.
When they talk about you, know you are at the end of them.
Yeah.
If they are backbiting mm-hmm. you know they are behind.
Yes.
And you need to move.
Yes.
Keep on moving. That is the only way to avoid backbiters.
Hallelujah.
Keep on moving to
yes.
your destination.
Yes.
Keep on moving to your direction. As you keep moving, you will lose them. You will lose them.
Yeah.
And when you lose them, they will no longer be there to criticize you. Prove by living a righteous life, God will cause you to bear fruit.
Amen.
And once you bear fruit, the enemy will stop And they will not continue to criticize you. They cannot see this is no fruits when they see them. They will see the fruits and then they will honor God because of your life. I pray in the name of Jesus that you shall be lifted above criticism. You will be lifted above every kind of accusation. That you know that your accusers are below you. In the name of Jesus, I pray like David. May God save you from the strange tongue.
May
God save you from the tongue of foreigners.
Save your marriage.
May God save that marriage from the tongue of foreigners.
Amen.
Those who are criticizing and they are stopping your fruitfulness by their mouths. May the Lord lift you up.
Amen.
May the Lord lift your marriage. May the Lord lift your family. May God secure you. May God put you in the place of safety.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus. May the God of heaven prove your opposers, prove your critics wrong by lifting your life, by making your marriage to look good and to be the best. In the name of Jesus. Those who are criticized because they don't have children, may God remember you and give you the fruit of your own. Whoever is criticizing you the way Anna used to be criticized by Peninnah, they're being to stand up, being to provoked, and being to oppressor and distressor. Whoever is positioned in your marriage to oppress you and cause distress in your marriage, in the name of Jesus Christ, may that turn into stirring and may you rise up in your marriage relationship.
Amen.
God, make you smile at your enemies. May you look at them straight in your at their faces and smile at them. May you smile at your enemies because the Lord has lifted up your marriage. If you hear me, I want to hear and better amen.
Amen.
May the Lord, you remembered Anna and lifted her above, lift you above.